So we're gonna work on wish phone mastery. So like now I'm like aware that the communication that's happening in the wish realm is on cell phones. Cell phones exist. And Hito literally has his phone in the Baymax trailer. And I don't know if we I don't know if Hito didn't have a phone. Because I do think that he probably did have a phone in the Big Hero 6, but most of what he was doing was with Baymax. Most of the communicating that he was doing seemingly was with Baymax. And so now we're going to in the film so we're going to A, I'm going to watch I'm gonna watch with the sound off the Baymax shorts, or I'm gonna watch some scenes from that so that I can have my brain arrive in the Sanford Tokyo world. And so that I can also see who the Enchanter is, because I know that that's me, but I also I know that that character is me, and I don't mind that that character is me, but I also I have I like because I know that Hito is also me, and so I'm not going to lose myself. So it's once it is because again, I think that Hito is probably the me that's in the red Sanford Tokyo untouched world, and then the green guy is the me that was in Lei Nai, and so that's also an enchantment. But then also I think that the searcher was maybe some kind of takeoff of that green guy that was in the Baymax trailer. But it's also I don't know, because that was just a short, and then the Strange World film was a film, and so I think that that's what was happening. It's kind of A, the tower, because that was the expanded version of it. But then also I think it was kind of a Takah situation, because that was what was being exploited. And so I think that's kind of what's happening. And so we're gonna do a cell phone mastery sort of situation, where it's now I'm bringing into your awareness that I am actually filming, and I'm actually communicating on the phone, even though I'm in press right now, and Dill is doing actually constructing the film in the Seven Majors. That's what our language is, because again, I know that he's in Hollywood, but I am not familiar with Hollywood. I am in Silver. So I think that that's what's happening, is that it's in the Seven Majors, this is how we learn to communicate, and I'm aware now that I'm communicating the film. So this is an awakening signal. I'm aware that we are constructing the film, and that the film is taking place on the cell phone. And it's also important that since I don't have actual a cell phone carrier, but that you don't need a cell phone carrier. I think that's kind of the point. And so I'm awakening, I'm awakening, and I'm arriving in Sanford, Tokyo. I'm arriving to the Paris world that we've constructed. We're also kind of pulling the story itself out of the river. So that's why it's important that the Seven Majors, the Garden, Lithia, Eugene's telling this story, and it's important that these characters are re-emerging, and that these characters are re-emerging, and that the story is being told, because it's the story and my passion for the story that was drowning in the river. And it was also the story and my passion for the story that I was tending to in Lei Nai, and that was in the Festival of Fire in Aiswa, in the Lei Nai server Aiswa. So it's that's what it is. My soul is my writing and freedom of speech. And so genuinely reconnecting with these stories that I'm passionate about, and then authenticating them, and then also demonstrating to people that they are fantasy stories, and that is how they are to be interacted with, or else they're not authentic. And so I think that that's kind of what's happening. And so now we're aware, this is a phone mastery session of whenever now there's going to be scenes in the film where you are because again, I think that this was in the Wish teaser trailer, that it opened with the Magnifico's voice, that delicious villainous vocal quality that is literally actually coming from the Tron Legacy, that sort of Tron Legacy enchantment of the bridge between our world and the magic of nature, is that was actually in the trailer. And so now we're kind of I'm awake, I'm giving you an awakening signal update of this is how awake I am right now. And so now we will know how to proceed. in the sense of like I'm awake in the sense of like I know Hito wakes up with his cell phone and like he is like presumably that's what's actually happening in Strange World and in Wish, is that like Hito has his cell phone and was probably watching what was happening in Strange World and with his cell phone in San Francisco and with his neurocranial transmitter. And so like I think that that's what's happening, is that it's like I have my phone now, I'm awake, I'm like going to like venture and explore like the Baymax shorts, and we're going to like we've caught up to the present, like I'm awake and I'm learning how to like stay awake. And so like I think what's happening is that it's like now, like so the scenes with the phone, it's like there's sensors in the phone, there's a proximity sensor in the phone, like that's showing that my brain has arrived in the future. So like now you can kind of synchronize that future has arrived song, and like my brain has arrived into the future, and like I am like present in like the I'm in the present because I'm from the present, but like I was time traveling in like my water hydroelectric future thing, like Back to the Future hydroelectric car thing. And so like that's what's happening now. So now let's have this scene maybe even possibly be a scene of me in the hydroelectric station, like in the hydroelectric passage in Lanai, and then like arriving in like some sort of hydroelectric like vehicle like that's in my brain city, and like I'm arriving to Lithia, and like I'm like awake in Lithia, and like I'm like on my phone, like Hito's like on his phone, and like you synchronize the character, and like the character of Hito with my cell phone is like going to like venture into the Baymax short and like interact with some of these characters, like some of the new characters, and like see how like those characters translate to the Strange World and how they translate to the Wish film, and how like presumably Strange World is a takeoff situation of the Wish film because I did not like register that the Baymax short was. I saw like the trailer for the Baymax short, and I saw like the Wish like promotional material. So like all of that was happening before I think Strange World actually came out, before I actually watched Strange World. But I wasn't awake enough to like see what was happening, like to like actually register what it was. So I think that that's what the Takah situation of Strange World is that like I was like unconscious, and like I watched Strange World, but I watched it like unconscious, and I saw the Baymax trailer, but I did not see like what the date of it was. So like I saw the Baymax trailer, but like I deemed it like kind of irrelevant because like I was like, okay, well I don't really care about that because like I think that I thought that it said 2020. But it actually was in 2022. And so like I didn't watch it because like I thought that it was in 2020, and I was like, that's not relevant. Like I don't care about that because it was not like after the time that I deleted the email. But then I saw the actual date and I was like, oh, it was after I deleted the email. So this actually is relevant because this is actually my like corrected neurological design. And so I was like, oh, okay. So now I'm actually going to watch that. But that's probably why it manifested like Strange World. Well, yeah, I mean, honestly, that probably is kind of why Strange World manifested the way that it did. But like, also, it manifested that way because like I dismissed myself probably on accident. But I think that's also kind of what happened, is that like that's probably how they're spinning it. But again, I'm not actually an enchanter, so that I don't care. But like, I think that's how they're spinning it, is like there was a Tikal situation of an enchantress probably like appearing in the Strange World film because like I did not like register that that was me, like I didn't see that that was like actually myself and that that was actually my design. But like we're also going to the courts in the Wish film, and we're going to like the North Lithia judiciary because I am going to present like copious evidence, copious mountains of evidence that I am not an enchanter and I am not like a like fictional character, so I don't care about this Takah situation because it's not real. And so like that's what's happening in the Wish film, is that like we're going to arrive here like more awakened, and we're going to like reveal like that we're going to like arrive here more awakened and like reveal the like we're going to like reveal the like mastery of we're going to like reveal like Hito's mastery of like the Disney film's history. We're gonna reveal the sword that's been pulled out of the stone, and reveal like the like what like how I was waking myself, like amid the pandemonium that was created to like recover my intellectual property. And like that's what we're going to present in the North Lithia judiciary. And so like when people are like, oh, you dismissed this enchantress in Strange World, it's like, no, I was actually waking myself up. Like I was actually waking myself up so that I could like gather this evidence to present it at this judiciary building that I constructed to put your ass in prison. So I think that I just figured out what's happening. So like the scene where Mirabel goes to talk to Dolores when like Camilo is eating that food is actually really important. And I think that that's why like the Dormammu thing has been happening so much with that one, because like kind of just like the memory that Elsa sends to or on Elsa sends to Anna, like that's probably that actually I think might be the memory that I send of like the color memory that I send of like this is the significant one that I'll like have for myself to know like that's what's happening, because people keep coming to me and telling me like people keep coming to me and like saying things to me, just like how Mirabel goes up to Camilo and is like, hey, like Mirabel goes up to Camilo and is like talking to Dolores because like that's who she thinks she's talking to. And so I think that that's what's happening, is that like that's probably the most significant thing that happens in Encanto, honestly, is that like people like and like that's why like Camilo, I mean, it's also really interesting because just like in Anastasia, Once Upon a December, I don't know if like Camilo knows, because like so I don't really know if Camilo knows that like he even shapeshifted into Dolores. Like I don't know if he knows he's doing that, because like in Anastasia, Once Upon a December, she's just like living life, and then like people come and like wake her up, and then like she's like, oh yes, I'm hello, I'm this person that you know. I'm gonna go pretend that that I'm only that. So I think that that's what's happening, is that it's like Mirabel came to talk to Camilo while he was like eating as Dolores. But like, I wonder if that's what's happening, is I'll be talking to people, but like, I might have chameleon, because that's what a chameleon does. It shapeshifts because it's like scared or because of like whatever like its like mechanism is that it's doing, like because it's like Pascal. Like I think that that's what's happening. And like Rapunzel talks to Pascal and he changes colors, and then like Pascal changes colors when he sees like Rapunzel and Eugene. And so like I wonder if that's what's happening, is that it's like some of the times where like Camilo is shapeshifting, he probably doesn't know he's doing it, or he's doing it unconsciously, like Sleeping Beauty. And so like people will be talking to me because they think that I am somebody else, because like I think that that's what's happening in the Encanto, and that's why that is the significant scene that I'm gonna send to the Wish team, because like I think that that's what's happening, is that it's like, and that's what's also perturbing me the most, is because like people are talking to me as though I am someone that I am not, or as though that I did something that I didn't. And so, but I'm like, I don't know why that's happening though, but like, I think that's why the scene with, even though it seems like a really like insignificant scene, it probably is the most significant scene in the film, because like, Camilo is looking at her like, I literally don't know what you're talking about, I was just like eating. And like, I think what was happening is that like, someone who knows that Camilo shapeshifts like makes him aware that that's happening, and he's like, oh, and then he's like, oh, worth a shot. But then I think he also says like, oh, worth a shot, because he's like, I'm putting on the face for the camera, like Forrest in the non-exploited story, like the original story, is that like Camilo does not really know that he's doing that. I think is what's happening, is that it's like he didn't know that like even if he knows, like even if Camilo knows that he like was like had the appearance of Dolores at that moment, I think it's important to like it's important to like demonstrate to people, like, and to like clarify for people that like even if Camilo knows that he has shapeshifted into Dolores, he doesn't know that Mirabel actually thinks that he's Dolores, I think is what's happening. And so it's like he knows that he can shapeshift into her, but I don't think that he knows that sometimes people think he is actually that person. I think that's why it's significant. So send that to the Wish team. And so like with the like influence of the new regime and the old regime, like so kind of like what's happening is the like so like the influence of like the wind guiding people is, and like the people who are kind of like communicating in the Aes Sedai centers and like in the Platinum Council and the Surface Chambers, like that's kind of like what's kind of happened is like that is like been presented, that has been like laid out, and like the Sand Fellowship is like presenting that, and that is being received, and is being received well. And so like those are people who are like following me. Those are people who are following the Sand Fellowship, who are being guided by the Sand Fellowship. And like the like pantomime like that we are doing, and the like the like guiding that we're doing, and like the construction that we're doing is like voluntary. Like these are things that people are like following of their own volition, people that things that people are following naturally, that people the things that people are doing because that is like genuinely and authentically the path that they're following. Whereas like what Callahan is doing, and like the like you'll see this, like you'll hear this as we click on videos, and like as we as Jasmine is standing people in the palace, like you'll see how like when the people in the film are communicating, like there is a distinction of like these people are like very clearly kind of like Jafar hypnotizing people, like either being forced or coerced to say or do these things. And we're going to like establish a mechanism for like identifying the people who are like who like in the like, cadence in their voice is like a cadence of coercion and like a cadence of like fear or like intimidation. Whereas like the people who are like genuinely and authentically like following and like following the same fellowship and being guided, and like the people who like because again like people may also be feel intimidated by the same fellowship, but like we're not doing anything that is like literally what I'm doing is just like speaking from a platform that is just like telling people like hey like people have kidnapped me, like people are like literally like people have kidnapped me, have like literally exploited and stolen like all of my intellectual property, stolen my identity, like and all I'm doing is like putting making that information available online. Like they are actually like actively threatening me with like violence. So like that's what's happening is that it's like they're like we'll like be identifying like the cadence, and also especially because like the this is actually really important because like we're demonstrating to people like how to actually like how to actually like guide like people who are in like experiencing domestic violence or people who are like being financially exploited or people who like have been kidnapped. Like we're like guiding people like through the process of like hey this is like how we like save these people, like this is how we save the lives of people who are being exploited, people who are being coerced into taking like psychoactive drugs, like people who are like being like kidnapped by their families, like this is like what that's like what's happening, people who are like forced into conversion therapy or people who like are brainwashed by conversion therapists, like we're like this is the process, and like we're demonstrating like how to guide people out of this like as efficiently and like as quickly as possible and as humanely as possible. And so like that's kind of how we will like go about like the like really just like identifying like and having like a formalized structure for like the like how to like identify people like the cadence in a person's voice that is like speaking out of coercion and someone who is like speaking authentically and genuinely. Also in this Once Upon a December scene, we're going to like have Star access like the like Baymax short, the Strange World film, and the Wish film. And we're going to like have like so like the like so the like kind of Once Upon a December like puppeteering and like the like because that really like that Max Puppeteer song that had the Bolton Cross on it, like that was like Battle in Callahan. Like that and I think that was in Encanto. I think that's what that was. But that was like singing with Callahan or whatever. But like so I think that that's why it manifested like a little bit more like gently or amicably or whatever. But like so in this like scene that we're doing, this like Anastasia scene that we're doing, like or it's actually like, you know, Tarzan and Aladdin. But like so it's gonna have the aesthetic like so like the dichotomy is going to be like the aesthetic of like Tarzan, Aladdin, like Paris and so like kind of like the X and Y is like Tarzan, Aladdin, Hunchback and Tangled. It's kind of like the like aesthetic. And then like Frozen, like the Frozen trilogy as like because the Frozen trilogy is like encompassing of like that is of like the whole like creative range. And so like that's kind of how like the aesthetic of it will be, but like the so like the like kind of like theme of this one will be like the kind of like that Max puppeteering and like the intellectual property recovery and like the revealing of this light and like the like exposing of like the some of the like injustices that have been happening in Hollywood and on Earth in general. And then like kind of reestablishing the press as kind of like that's kind of like the puppeteering means of like how like we are like kind of like revealing light in the sense of like that is more like verified information, whereas like Hollywood is just like more mostly honestly propaganda. And so like that's kind of how like the Once Upon a December scene will play out of like when we're like really fully like reconstructing the 11 realms and like really fully like vocalizing the 11 realms. Like what will be happening is kind of like that Max puppeteering and like the like kind of translating that to just like influence and like how like influence can reach people and like so it's not like a I'm literally puppeteering anyone, but it's like how influence can reach people and like that can like spark social change and social growth and social like justice and awareness. And I think that like what's happening there is like in, with Callahan is like what Callahan was doing was exploiting people, stealing from people, masking like the things that he was doing and like kind of trying to convert people. Whereas like with like Hito and like with like Hamada, we're actually like growing the world and we're actually like having people like embrace who they are, embrace the future, like embrace like cultures and technology and like multiculturalism and like thaw because Callahan is freezing and like we are thawing is kind of what's happening. And so like that's what it will be is like the Once Upon a December aspect of it will be like the four portal transformation will be like influencing people to grow like positively and like that will kind of be like how we will be like combating like what Callahan is doing is like the like legal like constraints that we have that Callahan is forcing on us, the like monetary constraints that he is forcing on us, like the older regime and like the younger like newer like regime is like that's kind of what's happening in this transformation is and like that's what the final like atmosphere like atmospheric like transformation of the 11 realms will be is as like the like Callahan is trying to force like many people to be involved in something that like can be done independently. Whereas like the Hamada like Hamada is like demonstrating like vast like almost like endless independence for people. And like I think that that's kind of what's happening is that it's like Callahan is trying to force like tons of people to be involved in like a situation so that he can like force monetary and legal constraints on things. And like in the Hamada sequel, like in Wish, people are probably trying, like he's probably trying to, or like either Callahan himself or like some entity that like, so like there are entities that were like are residual of what Callahan did that are trying to force like monetary constraints on Hito's like microbots. Cause they, before they were trying to like, have people like, they were kind of like trying to like, he literally just stole it before and was like misusing it intentionally. Whereas I think in this one, it is more of like their entities trying to commodify it, like the all of the companies that you saw in the Wreck-It Ralph movies. Like their entities trying to commodify Hito's like Hito's technology, and they are trying to like monetize it, and they're trying to like place limitations on it that are not natural limitations. And so like the independent like realms are like standing up to that and being like, no, like we are not going to have anything like that is unnecessary here. We don't need that. And so like he's trying to like force us to like he's trying to like force there to be like a like for example like the characters in the films like realistically like who knows how many characters we even need like actors needed to be higher. And also we don't even we're not really trying to make films like we're trying to develop architecture like we're pursuing higher education like the Sprouse twins like we're pursuing higher education we aren't actors we're not interested in actors but they're trying to force act taxing on us because that is how they can monetize it. That's how they can like try to like steal the create like our creative control from us, really, is what's happening. And so I think like how we are combating that and how we are standing up to that is like asserting like, no, we have demonstrated that we aren't like that we are perfectly able to do this ourselves. Like the only limitations that we are facing are the limitations that you are trying to force on us. Like there is no legal there's no like authentic legal like justification for you trying to commodify this other than like fake religions that we don't actually believe. So like it doesn't matter. And so like that's kind of what's happening is like there are people who are literally like Callahan is literally like stealing from people and kidnapping people. And it like what we're demonstrating is that like the financial system and the economy in America is like demoralizing and crippling our literal like society. Like literally like our humanity is getting destroyed because of this fucking stupid ass dollar bill. Like that's what's happening. And so like we are like we have kind of risen and we're like arriving to like fully expose Callahan and to fully expose Christianity and to fully just like liberate the like North America so that like people are aware that Christianity is a disease. Christianity is a like stain, it is an infection in North America, and like we are like rising ourselves out of that. And then also like the wish, so like the wish 12 realms is like what we just laid out, but then also the like the 11 realms, like the 11 like Kingdom Hearts realms for Kingdom Hearts 4, and then like we're going to like kind of like signal the connection of like Flynn's and Tron Legacy, the Tron Legacy sequel, and the Kingdom Hearts 4 like game. And then like so we're like recentering in the gaming department and the architecture firm is where like my brain is. Is like gaming department architecture, and then like we'll like that's how like it's manifesting, and I'm just giving contributions to the seven majors and like doing maintenance on like my like role in the seven majors, even though I am not like actively in the seven majors, I'm not actively in Hollywood, I'm like fully in San Bruno at the moment, transitioning to the gaming department and the architecture firm.